Black Hebrew Israelites are groups of Black Americans who believe that they are descendants of the ancient Israelites. Black Hebrews adhere in varying degrees to the religious beliefs and practices of both Christianity and Judaism. With the exception of a small number of individuals who have formally converted to Judaism, they are not recognized as Jews by the greater Jewish community.
This Wednesday, my podcast with Vocab Malone. It's on Black Hebrew Israelites in part, which is one of the most searched items on equip.org website and something that you've probably been exposed to, whether you realize it or not.
The primacy that they give to their identity doctrine. What I mean is they want to make this claim about who they are. It's the most important thing. It's the golden goose,
Urban apologetics and being equipped with essential Christian doctrine. We hope you enjoy the energy, the information, the insights from Vocab as much as we did.
Rabbi, if you have a shot, how may I help you? Oh, yes, sir. Okay, hold on. Listen, I've got a meeting in 5 minutes, so I have to make it quick. Call him a cracker. An Edomite. Oh, he's black. He's black, is he? Well, so-called black, we both know that. I'm from the tribe of Ephraim, by the way. Okay, call him a coon. Yes, yes. A coon, a sellout, an Uncle Tom. Any of those should work fine. Yes, private eye for Yahweh Shai. At your service. Thank you very much.
And glory to Yahweh, Bahashem Yahawashai, Bahashem Rakaha Kadash, and the Bohana to the Elden Apostle of the Timison who do well. Peace, blessing, and salutation to you, Akiam, who are pushing these truths to the four winds of the heaven and be on the forefront of this spiritual war to make sure Jerusalem is established as a praise here on earth again. It's your brother Yeshaya coming to you again with this precept. You see, 25 is the sheep of Yahweh Hashem Yahawashai. And then what you saw, like there is like a documentary, see, by this heathen, see, about the Hebrew Israelite, you tribesmen, you Negro and Latin and Native America. See, and the whole purpose of this documentary or things like this is first and foremost is to frustrate our purpose. You see, like how it happened with our forefather Ezra, Zerubbabel, and the high priest Joshua, to frustrate our purpose and to weaken our hand. And then, what really is this? We breed a physical confrontation. So it is safe to say that the enemy is closing in, man. See, the enemy is closing in. You see, that documentary also will be used, you see, to persecute you brothers who are in this truth. You see, and then this, on the other hand, it should act like a sign to you and believers, man, that we got the truth, man. You see, and this is the trumpet, man, which signify the enemy is coming. You see, the watchmen are telling you that the enemy is closing in. You see, because the thing is, When Esau came down on you tribes, man, he won't separate that you were in this truth or you was not. That's why it is called Jacob trouble. And the Lord won't do anything, man. He won't bring anything, you see, unless he tell his servant, the prophet, man. And the prophet, they are referred as watchmen. They stay on the doorpost, you see, to tell you that the enemy is approaching, man. You see? And being the watchman, man, you have to learn how to pipe the trumpet. If somebody is approaching the doorpost and you recognize that it is your ally, you pipe the trumpet, which signifies that the enemy is coming with peace. See, the enemy is coming with peace. See, if you see that the enemy is not coming with peace, you pipe another sound. We call it an eerie sound. To alarm your brothers that the enemy is coming, prepare, the enemy is coming. You see, put your house in order, man. You see? So, this is a book of 2 Samuel 18 and verse 24. It say, and David sat between the two gates, and the watchman went up to the roof over the gate onto the wall, and lift up his eye and looked, and behold, a man standing alone. And the watchman cried, you see, that is the whole purpose of the watchman, man, or the prophet, cried and told the king, and the king said, if he be alone, there is tidings in his mouth, and he came apace and drew nigh, and the watchman saw another man running, and the watchman called unto the porter and said, behold, another man running alone, and the king said, he also bringeth a tidings. You see, so the prophet are here, man, to tell you, you see, the enemy is approaching, man. You see, the enemy is approaching, and the enemy is coming with something, man. You see, the enemy is coming with something, and that thing is persecution, man. The enemy is bringing death, man, mass death and judgment, man. And we always tell you your enemy is Esau, man. You see, we identify the enemy to you that is Esau. We don't only identify the enemy. We tell you how to prepare, man, to face the enemy. You see, so this is Ezra 4, starting at verse 1. It says, now when the adversary of Judah and Benjamin heard that the children of the captivity builded the temple unto the Lord God of Israel, Yahweh Hashem Yahushai. So the children of captivity are your tribes right now, man. There's nothing new under the sun. Then they came to Zerubbabel and to the chief of the fathers and said unto them, let us build with you, for we seek your God as he do, and we do sacrifice unto him since the days of Esarhaddon, king of Ashur. So this is going to now it's going to Christianity, man. People like Vocab Maloney, see, they say the same Jesus you are calling, the same Jesus we are calling. You see, but really, when you go deep, the Jesus they are calling is not the Jesus, the Lord you are calling, Yahweh, man. See, they are worshiping a false deity. We are worshiping the living power, man. You see. And but Zerubbabel and Joshua and the rest of the chief of the fathers of Israel said unto them, you have nothing to do with us to build a house unto our God, but we ourselves together we build unto the Lord God of Israel, as King Cyrus, the king of Persia, has commanded us. Then the people of the land weakened the hand of the people of Judah and troubled them in building. That's why they are doing, man. That's why you are seeing all of this mockery, man. You see, the whole purpose is to weaken our hand, man. See, all of that mockery in the highway and byway, all of this documentary coming against they're trying to dig into everything, every doctrine, man, to weaken the house of David, because the house of David, let me see. The house of David, let's go to the
book of Amos 9, you see, on the 11th, saying, that day I will raise up the tabernacle of David that is fallen and close up the branch. Therefore, and the branch is going to the difference we have, man. You see, when the elder starting teaching the true doctrine, man, you see, it reached a point where they have to separate, man, because the lawyer breaches in terms of doctrine. See, this group believed this group believed this, so they have to separate. But right now, starting with your elder apostle in Great, here in Great Nation, man, we are teaching the pure doctrine. And this thing is evolving. This thing is evolving in terms of doctrine, you see, in terms of faith. You see, that faith of mustard seed, which started with our elder and apostle, is growing to a bigger tree. So the branches are closing in. So these enemies, what they are doing is they are looking in between the branches and trying to dig in, you see, to dig in so that they can find a weakness, man. But that ain't going to happen because the one who crossed the branch in the house of David is the Lord himself, man. You see, let's continue. And I will raise up his ruin and I will build in the days as in the days of old. See, going back to the book of Ezra 4, see, verse 5, and say, and they hired the counselors against them to frustrate their purpose all the day of Cyrus, king of Persia, even until the regain of Darius, king of Persia. You see, so that is the whole purpose of this season, man. So going back to the trumpet, man, you see, like how we read that watchman who was staying on the doorpost of King David, you see, his whole purpose was to pipe in the trumpet or to shout that the enemy is coming with peace or is coming with violence, man, you see. So there is two types of trumpet, man. A trumpet for solemn feast and a trumpet for war. You see, so let's go to Matthew 11 and 16. It say, but whereunto shall ye liken this generation? It is like unto children sitting in the marketplace and calling unto their fellows and saying, we have piped unto you and you have danced. Why they haven't danced, man? Because they can't differentiate which trumpet is which trumpet. The trumpet which signifies that this is a solemn feast, or this is a time to do myth and be all joy, and the trumpet that the enemy is closing in. They can't differentiate that. That's why the time to dance, they are sitting down. The time to sit down, they are dancing. The time to mourn, they are doing all kind of myth and folly, man. You see? We have mourned unto you, and you have not lamented. For John came neither eating nor drinking. They say he is a devil. And the Son of Man came eating and drinking. And they said, behold, a man gluttonous and a wine bibber, a friend of Republican and a sinner. But wisdom is justified of her children. So the Lord is breaking this down to you, even further. John came in this manner, and they said on another manner. The Son of Man came in this manner and said in that manner. So these people, they can't really know which time we're in, see. And as the Lord tell you, because they haven't been blessed with wisdom, man, the gift of wisdom. That's why they can't differentiate between this trumpet and that trumpet, man. See, to prove even further that you have trumpet, which signify war and peace, man. So this is 1 Corinthians 14 and 8, it say, for if the trumpet give an uncertain sound, and that's the job of a watchman, man. Being a watchman, that is a professional, man. When the enemy come and you can't give a certain sound, you can't produce a certain sound, you will cost the whole city, man. You see? And that blood of those people who will be killed, it will be required on you. You will see that, man. Who shall prepare himself to the battle? If you produce a certain sound, who will prepare to the battle? And this is going to you people who call yourself, who come under the ban of a prophet, and you are not telling your people that there will be Jacob trouble, and that there will be World War III, and that the mark of the beast is an RFID chip. And Esau is prepared to come down like a flood, man, forcing you to take the mark of the beast, forcing you to be under the new world order, man. Whereas the slogan of the new world order is expecting no mess, man. See, Esau will come forcing you to take the vaccine, which will ultimately change your genetic makeup, man. You see, it wasn't enough for him to change your genetic makeup when your whole health system via GMO food. Now he is going even further to inject something on you. So, the so-called prophet, man, the prophet of peace, man, and the solemnity, see, all of this myth and everything, man, they are not telling you the nitty-gritty, man. This prophet, man, they are giving you a sound of uncertainty. When is the enemy crossing, man, it will be trouble for you. See, it will be trouble for you. So let's see another scripture. This is the book of Luke 19 and 43. It says, "For the day shall come upon thee that thy enemy shall cast a trench about thee." And through the spirit of Yahweh Hashem Yahshai, we are able to foresee, because we are spiritual weathermen over here in GMS, man, starting with our elder apostle. We are able to foresee that the enemy is closing in. See, the enemy is about to cast a trench, man. By the movement of this hiring, this vocab Malone and his minion, you see these different people, man. And that dude in that video, he told you the Hebrew Israeli thing is the most searchable thing, because Esau has this different technology. He's able to see what word is more searchable in the internet. You see, the Hebrew Israeli, man, is the new thing in town, man. That fame, man. So Esau is doing a research on you, man, getting ready to come down on you. He will come down on you. He have all the information on you, and you don't know anything, man, because your prophet have been giving you a sound of uncertainty. See? Cast a trench about thee and compass thee round and keep thee in on every side. He will catch you unaware, man. So these things are serious, man. So let's go to Ezekiel 3:17. It say, "Son of man, I have made thee a watchman unto the house of Israel. Therefore hear the word of my mouth, and give them warning from me. When I say unto the wicked, thou shalt surely die, and thou givest him not warning, nor speak to one the wicked from his wicked way to save his life, the same wicked man shall die in his injustice, but his blood will I cry at thy hand. That is the importance of being a watchman. You see? Much will be required from you. If you give a sound of uncertainty, man, because the Lord refer Israel as a lost sheep, they don't know, they can't differentiate between, how dumb and stupid the nation of Israel, yeah, man. See, that's why you need to tell them with certainty, not I think it is this, I think it is that. No, man. See? So, this is Jonah 4. And 10, it says, "Then said the Lord, Yahweh Hashem Zarashai, thou hast had pity on the gorge, for the which thou hast not labored, neither made it grow, which came up in the night and perished in the night. And should not I spare Nineveh, that great city, wherein are more than 60,000 persons, and those are Israel, man?" And Nineveh, right now, it is America, man. Another name for America is Nineveh, because of witchcraft, man. And ancient Nineveh was heavy on witchcraft, man, like America, that cannot discern between their right hand and their left hand, and so much cattle. So you have Israel who can't discern their right hand from the left hand. See, why? Because of the corruption of this society, of this system, man. They don't even know how to be a man. They don't even know simple things like you become a man at age 12. See? They don't know the do and the don't of a man. See, I will do another lesson about that, the do and the don't of a man. See? They don't know which is to be eaten and which is not to be eaten. Let alone knowing the mark of the beast is of our Egypt. So if you produce the sound of uncertainty, let's go back, man. Let's go back to 1 Corinthians 14 and 8. It says, for if the trumpet give an uncertain sound, who shall prepare himself for battle? You see? Who shall prepare himself for battle? And finishing, let me finish with the book of Ezekiel 9. Starting at verse 5, this is what is coming, man. For you people who we tell you to dance, you sit down. We tell you to sit down, you dance. We tell you to wear sackcloth, you wear all fancy clothes, man. You people who indulge in fall, man, this is your judgment, man. Ezekiel 9:5 would say, and to the other he said, in my hearing, go ye after him, though in the city, and smite, let not your eye spare, neither have you pity. For you people who did not want to dance to the tune of this truth, man. You see? Slay utterly all young, both maiden, little children, women, man. For you people who think the Lord can't do this, the Lord can't kill, the Lord don't hate, man. The scripture say, tell you, slay utterly all young, both maiden, little children, women, but come not near any man upon whom is a marking. You see? Is a mark and a beginning at my sanctuary. Then they began at the ancient men which were before the house. You see? So, amen. The enemy is coming, man. The enemy will cast a trench upon thee.
In a moment, I'm going to burn, and he's going to be a slug.
Kawasaki! Ninja!
Shut up, Holmes!
You see all this?
Let me just say. This is coming with a lot of caution, okay?
Yes.
Go to YouTube and type in Black Hebrew Israelites. I got to have a serious caution, like, attached to that, because The stuff that you will get is...
Vile.
Vile. I mean, it's bad. Some stuff is not so bad. Some stuff is really, really bad, and so you don't want your kids around, I think, in the room when you are investigating this because of the content, the language. It's pretty bad. So, okay, Black Hebrew Israelites... very aggressive, very offensive oftentimes, and they're not all like that, but that's what you'll see a lot of on social media, and if you run into them in the streets. Let's start with this question. Who are the Black Hebrew Israelites?
Hi, Shalom. I'm going to begin this lesson by giving up.
And I want to finish by saying this was like my 2 cents on the elder brother from a GMS over there in Alabama, see, from the channel GMS Mystery of the Kingdom. If you haven't subscribe, you see, and continue keeping your spiritual bank account, man. And I want to finish by giving all praise and honor and glory to Yahweh Bahashem Yahushai, Bahashem Rakah HaKadash, and Abu Hana to the Elder and Apostle of the Mission who do well. Peace and blessing and salutation to you, Akiamua, pushing this truth to the four winds of heaven, be on the forefront to make sure Jerusalem is established as a praise here on the earth again. Shalom. To the next year, I hope you are edified.